Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2056, Power Query Squared. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gillen. I came across this trick while I was preparing to do a seminar at a conference in Dallas called Excelapalooza. Greatest Excel conference name ever. You should check it out every September in Dallas. And credit to Ken Puls and Miguel Escobar, because I had to do an hour on Power Query. So, of course, I pulled out their awesome book, the world's greatest book on Power Query. And I was flipping through the book and I saw they had one technique. And I said, wait a second, I'm going to see if I can adapt this technique. And this, to me, is awesome in Power Query. And here's what we're going to do. We're going to take one Power Query and then we're going to run that Power Query, that query, dozens of times. All right. And so the example that I came up with was where I wanted to pull data from a web page, all right? And I went out to, I just looked for some web page that I could use as an example. And I ended up at Weather Underground, and here's the URL. And you can see that I was in Dallas-Fort Worth, so we're pulling data for Dallas in, it looks like January 2nd, 2015. So right there in the URL is the parameters, right? And that is a URL that is just ripe for making this thing work. We'll take a quick look at the web page, although it's not so important. You see, there's a lot of different data out here on the web page, and I decided I was just going to try and get precipitation and high and low temperature. And here's that query. And let me tell you right here that this podcast is not about how to create this query. New query from other sources, from web. Specify the URL, and then a bunch of steps that I'm not going to detail here to get my final answer of max temp, min temp, and precipitation. The point is, you're going to take your own query and make it work for a bunch of things. So I click close and load, and this query is working. It's returning my one row. Everything is awesome. And I'm going to come back in, I'm going to edit this query, and I'm going to go to View, Advanced Editor. I'm going to take this query and I'm going to make it be a function. All right, so right here before the word let, I press enter, and in parentheses, I'm going to give it a variable, my URL, and then equal sign greater than, a little arrow there, right? Cool. And then down here where they have the URL in quotes, I want to get rid of the entire URL, including the quotes, and then type my variable name, my URL. All right, so what we're saying is we're going to pass it a URL, and it's going to do that same query, but with whatever URL we happen to pass it. Now, a couple of disconcerting things here. When I click done, oh man, all my applied steps are gone, and they want me to enter a parameter. Just ignore all that. We're going to rename this. We're going to call it FX weather. FX, of course, being the abbreviation for function. And you have to really remember this name and remember which letters are capitalized. That's going to be very important in a couple of minutes. Home. Close and load, and bam, everything is gone. Oh no, but that's okay. All right, so we know it's there, it's a connection only. Now I'm going to come over here, and this is just straight old Excel, right? So here's the URL. I broke it out into the first part of the URL, the ending part of the URL. I know that I need to take the date, I need to format it in this weird format of year, month, and day, so I use the text function to do that. Put in a starting date here. I can even change the airport. So now I'm back in Florida. Let's do MCO for Orlando, and let's do some recent data. So we'll start at 10/1/2016. All right, so now we have this great little table set up here. And by the way, it does have to be a table. You have to use format as table or control T. So you know, this is just grabbing that date and then plus one, plus one, plus one. I format it, I build the URL. All right, now we're gonna build a query from this table. All right, and there's my information. I'm going to add a new column, add a custom column. The columns are going to be called weather, and the form is going to be equal FX weather. Make sure it's the exact same case, same upper and lowercase letters, and we'll insert that field called URL like that, closing parentheses, no syntax errors. Click OK. They want to know about privacy here. This is all public data. Click save. All right, so there's our date. It's funny, they've actually changed my format into something that doesn't look like what I started out with. And then here's weather with the expand symbol. So I'm going to click the expand symbol, uncheck use original column name as prefix. I want the max, the min, the precipitation. Click OK. All right, And now all I need is the date and that information out there. So I'll right click and remove this column, right click and remove this column. Over here, I don't need that time, so I'll say that this is just a date. All right. And see what it's doing. Every date that I'm passing it, it's returning the high, the low, and the precipitation for Orlando. Every row here is going out to a different web page. Just imagine if it wasn't 15 rows, but 5,000 rows, you'd set it up to run overnight. I used to write macros for this. In fact, one of the web pages out at Mr. Excel is how to build a macro to scrape web pages from 1,000 different web pages at a site. Not necessary anymore with Power Query. Now, when I close and load, it's funny, the preview here is showing me all the results. When I close and load, they're actually going to go do each query. And so right now we have preview rows loaded, and it will take a good long time for this information to get updated. So go to lunch, do something, especially if you're doing more than 15 rows. And it's funny, the preview is correct, but they're still going out and ka-chunk, ka-chunk, ka-chunking through each individual row. And there it's loaded. Is this amazing or what? Now, hey, I do a lot of Excel seminars, the Power Excel seminar in Orlando, Florida. Look at these beautiful temperatures we have down here. November 4th, 2016, my afternoon will be all about Power Query, Power BI, Power Pivot, Power Map. So I'm going to invite you down to Orlando to check out this seminar. There'll be a link there in the top right-hand corner. All right, so recap. Today's trick is from this book, M is for Data Monkey. We build a query to get one web page and then edit that query to change it into a function. So right before the let statement, variable name equals greater than, and then change the hard-coded URL to whatever that variable name is, rename the query to FX weather, close and load, the data disappears. Then we use some sort of Excel trickery to create a table of all the URLs we want to crawl, create a query from that table, this has to be a control T table, add a new column of weather equals equal FX weather, and again it has to match the case there, square brackets URL, expand that column, uncheck prefix, bam, it is amazing. Thanks to Ken and Miguel for writing this book. Thanks to you for stopping by. Hope to see you in Orlando on November 4th, 2016. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.